Welcome to Naki's vlog. I'm going to discuss today the three matches. The first one is the Pakistan and Australia, the second England and New Zealand, and third one is the India and Bangladesh. So the first one is Pakistan and Australia. It was really an emotional start for Naseem Shah. Naseem Shah was just 16 years and 279 days. He became ninth youngest debutant for Pakistan, and he also became in the history of Test cricket, and he also became the sixth youngest Test cricketer for Pakistan. I would say the previous, I'm going to tell you the previous record also, which was the Ian Grage for Australia in 1953 at Melbourne, and he was also 17 years and 239 days. So the first thing which I'm going to discuss today is the Pakistan and Australia cricket match. Now, once again, Pakistan, they won the toss and elected to bat first. Pakistan, they had really good partnership of 75 runs between Shan Masood and Azhar Ali. And once again, Pakistan couldn't capitalize, and the middle order collapsed badly. They were 95 for 6 suddenly after lunch. And the problem, the same thing which I said in my video yesterday, Pakistan need to work on their strike rate in Australia. There is a mental blockage. And as I said yesterday in my previous video, that if Pakistan, they stop and they don't try to score runs like 3, 4, 5 in every over, yes, I understand, outside off stump, they need to leave the balls outside off stump, but they need to play the cover drive also to just keep ticking that strike rate. Because if they... the problem is the mindset. If they think they are playing in UAE, Pakistan, or Sri Lanka, or India, that the cricket is different there. In Australia, they normally, Australians, they score 310, 320 runs in a day in 90 overs, and that's where the problem was. Pakistan, they thought that with the new ball, they just have to wait for the new ball, play 20, 25 overs, and then everything will be fine. Scoring runs will be easier for them, but no, that didn't work. The problem is the old ball also in Australia, the old ball also seam and swing. And that's the trouble, that's where the problem was. And that's what exactly happened with Pakistan. The scores, the standout scores for Pakistan, the Shan Masood 27, Azhar Ali 39, Asad Shafiq 76. That was really good, because Asad Shafiq started from where he left last time in 2016. He scored a century in Kaaba, and the score 76 run was really useful for Pakistan, because Pakistan would have ended 160, 170 if he would have not scored those 76 runs. And again, the Yasir Shah, he scored really useful runs for Pakistan. Now, there was a lot of criticism on social media today. Even though Ricky Ponting, Brett Lee, everyone was saying that there is a problem with the umpiring standard, umpiring errors, that's costing teams, and that's what exactly happened. Rizwan was given out on a no ball, and we saw in the World Cup all the criticism the ICC they had after, when we saw that Dharmasena mistakenly gave like extra runs to England, and then the trouble was, in fact, the cricket analysts, they were even saying that the trophy should be shared between New Zealand and England, because that was umpiring error. And also ICC, they need to do quite a lot work on that. The umpiring standard has really gone down, and that's costing teams now. That's what happened with Pakistan. Had Rizwan scored for Pakistan another 30-40 runs, Pakistan would have ended scoring 282-90, and that would have been really useful for Pakistan, but that didn't work. Now, the second match I'm going to talk about is England and New Zealand. Again, once again, the England, they won the toss and decided to bat first. The standout players for England was Ben Stokes, 67. He scored. Burns, he scored 52. Denley, he scored 74 runs. Once again, Ben Stokes, he has been tremendous. He has been stupendous for England for so many years now, for last 2-3 years, that he is scoring runs everywhere for them, for England. And he just comes low down the order. Whatever position England, they ask him to play, even three down, four down, maybe after, he just come and score the runs. And they, I would say at the moment, if England, they manage to score 400, 450, and if they try to bowl New Zealand out and get a lead of 100, 150 runs, then the situation will be really difficult for New Zealand. But I would say it's not easy to beat New Zealand. In New Zealand, they will come hard, especially Williamson is back in their team after injury, and it won't be easy. So my prediction for New Zealand, England, that if England, they bat tomorrow, the match them that might ended in a draw. But for Pakistan and Australia, if they manage to get a lead of 70, 80 or even 100 runs, game over for Pakistan. I don't think so. Pakistan, they're gonna get rid of that lead. So Pakistan need to get Australia out as soon as possible tomorrow, and pitch might be settled, so you never know. They might try to get a lead of 100, 150 and then game over for Pakistan. The third match I'm going to talk about is India and Bangladesh. India, again, I would say that will be a match starting tomorrow, and that will be a day-night match. India, they refused to play the last day-night match against Australia because they were not used to conditions. Now they are saying, now they have got an opportunity to play a day-night match, and especially they are playing at home. So I would say there will be once again a one-sided match. Bangladesh is nowhere near India, so the test match might end in a 3 days or maybe 2.5 days. So, and I'm because India is now getting ready for the tours of New Zealand and Australia, that's why they are having green pitches, and that's why they are making the pitches for their pacers. That's what they are exactly doing. Now, the fourth thing I will talk about is the Asian Emerging Championship. The Asian Emerging, Bangladesh, they qualified for finals today after beating Afghanistan, and they are playing Pakistan on Saturday. And as I said, that Pakistan is favorite for the final on Saturday. And then the last thing is my son's birthday today. He's 3 today. I'm going to share some pictures on my video. Please, if you like my video, please share it. And also, please don't forget to press the bell button on the right bottom. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.